This is going to be a quick edit episode so that I can show how to do some simple twilight photography. We're going to take some simple shots. We're going to take this one here and turn it into this. This is very simple to do. There's a little bit more footage though that we're going to capture along the way. So a couple things here just to start off with, some of the settings that you're going to use. Keep your white balance at about 5500 Kelvin or 5000 Kelvin. That way you'll get naturally a nice warm tone to the picture. We're going to be changing the sky though, which really makes it impactful. Sometimes you don't have to, but a lot of times that really will work best. So we're going to capture extra footage for that, and I'll talk about that. But besides the 5500 Kelvin white balance, the rest of it really is almost up to you. It's going to be done on a tripod. You're going to be using some type of shutter release. So you can go down to ISO 100, ISO 200, using about F8. The trick is that your shutter speed shouldn't be too fast if you have a little bit of wind. Otherwise, you're going to get blur as trees and leaves move back and forth. But other than that, a lot of times I'm shooting at about maybe a half a second, maybe 1/10 of a second at the fastest, using about ISO 100, ISO 200. But that's really up to you. Now, the longer that you leave the shutter open, the better your starburst flares will be. So that's just something else to keep in mind for exposure settings. But let's start with the footage and then how to edit this real quick. So this is the final image here, but we took the footage from here. This was a first shot, then taking another shot, taking another shot, basically a bracket, but I tend to do these just manual so that I can see how much I'm changing for darkness, not relying on just an automatic exposure bracket. But all that I really needed out of this was just this, because this exposes the house very well, and I know it doesn't look impactful just being a raw file, and you notice too, the sky is just boring. So this sky's okay. Okay, we are going to use this though, because it's going to make the sky swap that we're going to do a little better. One, by being able to let the house be highlighted. So let's go into the editing process. All that I do, by the way, when I do these, you can bring them in as raw files, but like I show in my exteriors book, I like to be able to bring these as TIFFs. So I use OEM software to bring that in. And by the way, if you're not familiar with that, I've linked to that book and also my real estate photography series down in the description for this video. But either case, all I would do is take these two images, right click on that and say edit in, and then open as layers in Photoshop. So they're opened in Photoshop now, and you can see at the very top, that's our base exposure. Down here is then that darker exposure. I have an image over here that I took of a sky. It was from another night many years ago. And whenever you see a really good sunset twilight type of clouds, get out there and capture it. Save it into your collection. There's no need to be paying for twilight skies and presets. I'm going to show you all that in this video. But it's a great, fun project. Make it for yourself one night. Many nights, go out there and capture yourself some of these twilight sunset type of clouds and skies. So anyways, getting to the editing portion then back here, the trick is first, let's take our dark exposure and move that layer up to the very top. Then what I like to do is to go to select and sky, and that's going to get us a starting point of where the sky should be. Then go down here and click this little mask icon. Now, it didn't select the trees and everything, and that's something that we want to do. Once again, this got us a nice starting point, and also to be a good base to do our sky swap on. Zoom out a little bit. Use a brush, fairly large size, and here I'm going to use a 30% flow, and I'm going to brush in over top of where those trees are, and that's it. Now we have something to work with our sky. So the next thing I'm going to do is go to the sky exposure. I'm going to click that. I'm going to do Control A to select it all, Control C to copy it. Go back over here, and at the very top, do Control V to paste it. Now I'm going to change its layer opacity down to about 60%. That allows me to decide where I want to put it. Then using the move tool, I'm going to move that into place. And I can see that, yeah, most of the impactful stuff is probably then off to the right. I don't want that. So I'm just going to flip it. I'm going to go up here to edit, and I'm going to go to transform, and then I'm going to flip that horizontally. Now I've got something. If we take a look at about 90%, you'd see where that would be. It looks good. Change that opacity down, move it into place where I think that would be a nice looking sky. Once that's done, then just change the opacity back to 100% and put a layer mask on it. I'm going to go layer, mask, hide all. Now, here's the trick of getting a really good twilight sky swap. Don't use the sky that we just added in here from this layer. Select the base layer, which was brighter. Select that and now go up to, once again, select sky. And it's going to be selecting the brightest areas, which will be then you can see inside where the trees are. This gives us a better feathering effect. Go back up to the mask for that sky layer. Reverse your colors so that over here they're white and black, but you want them black and white. So do that by pressing X on your keyboard. Now they're black and white. On that mask, press the delete key. Now, do Control D to deselect, press X again to reverse your colors. Now, when we take a look at this, we can see that it's starting to look like a good twilight shot, but the sky itself is still kind of bright, kind of daytime-ish. So I really like to pump up the sky. And to do that, let's just zoom out to see what we're doing a little bit better. And we're going to add an adjustment layer, and we're going to clip it to that sky. So you go up to Layer, New Adjustment Layer, and select a Levels Layer. Name it whatever you'd like. In here, there's a little icon here. Click that. Now we'll add a clipping mask with that little arrow, meaning that it's only affecting the layer directly below it, in this case, the sky. You can then start changing the levels. So the biggest thing for skies on twilights is to pump up the dark level, and we're going to move then this left slider over. You can see what that's doing to the colors. It's really richening them up. Usually you don't need to move the whites in. You can see it starts blowing out highlights. So I usually leave it just like that. Now we've got something that looks pretty good, and what we should do at this point, we're going to go back and forth between Lightroom to see how well we might want to adjust anything else. If at this point though you have blown out lights, what you can do is very lightly brush in from the darker exposure some of those areas. So for instance, if we felt that this was just a little bit overblown over here, what you can do is you can take a brush at a very low flow, so I'll take the brush tool, and I'm going to change the flow up here to about, let's say, 10% or so. So once we get that to where we'd like it with a decent flow, let's just use 11%, then I can take the brush and then lightly tap in where I'd like some of that reduction in light to be. So that will tone those down. So you can see this was what it was before, and you can see this is after I toned it down. You can do that to your liking, and that's also why sometimes it's better to take a lot of other exposures. So there's a couple things that the sky also filled in. I'm not going to worry about them too much because up here there's a little bit of a net type of chimney. So you can see that without the sky that's showing up. And if you wanted to, you could get picky, take an eraser tool, and at a very low flow, let's use about 30% flow on this. And with about 30% flow, you can erase some of that right around there. And that will usually be good enough for something like that, or use the quick selection tool. But at this point now, what I like to do is save it as a Photoshop file and then take it back into Lightroom automatically. So we'll just go ahead and save as, and then we'll save it as a Photoshop file. Once we do that and it goes back into Lightroom, then we'll make some adjustments. So you can see now we have that loaded up into Lightroom. Now, to make sure that that did save to the proper directory, note that Photoshop has had a bug in some versions where if you were to flatten the file and save it as a TIFF, it'll automatically load. But when you save it as something else like a Photoshop file, you usually have to specify the exact directory where the file originated from. Small bug. Anyways, this is now back into Lightroom that's been loaded up, and I'm going to just apply a preset and show you what those settings are. It's a common one I was using in 2022, so I saved it as Twilight 2022. I'm going to press that, and immediately now we have a pretty good, almost finished image. And if you want to pause it right here, you can see this was all that was done for the preset. Now you could also add any sharpening or anything else you want to do, and this will also vary based off the type of sky that you're using and of course the exposure that you're using as well. If you noticed here, by using that 5500 Kelvin or 5000 Kelvin on your camera, sometimes they'll vary a little bit by color depending on your camera make and model, that we do have a nice amount of warmth. If you felt that this was a little bit too pinkish, which I feel that this being a white house, just a little bit too pink, let's lower the magenta down into the green by about 10. So we lower the tint by about 10. Now, if you wanted to change something else that's a little too warm, then you can also maybe lower the temperature a little bit and see how that looks. That really didn't do anything for it, so I'll just back that out. So these are things, though, that you would adjust based off the color time of day. Now, the trick to this was the time of day, and shooting this meant that to get the equalization image, which was this one here, where the light outside was equal to the light on the inside of the house, is 15 minutes after sunset. Sometimes that's also about 20 minutes after sunset, but when you're up against a house and you don't have equalization of light, you need to take more footage because the house doesn't have very well designed lighting. So usually about 15 minutes after, 20 minutes after will work well, and it did in this case because this was done very architecturally well for lighting, but sometimes it won't be, so that's where the other footage can come in to control that. But anyways, about 15 minutes, 20 minutes after you get this, but take a darker exposure, get that sky. Now, this is a real twilight shot done at twilight, 15 minutes or so after sunset, but you can also do this with during a daylight shot, you know, a day to dusk, a faux twilight. And you can take something that looks like this, turn it into this, and I have a tutorial on how to do that down in the description for this video. You'll find that link as well. But this is all that it takes to do these twilights. I did a few other ones, by the way, for this house. For instance, turning another direction, did this. You can see that that's the exact same sky. Turning around another direction, did this, and you can see this had the shutter open for longer, so there was a nice starburst flare that was able to come off of this. And then also near the front of the house, there was this shot here. And technically speaking, it was this. And you can see the difference when I go back is that there is a wet driveway that's here. And that was for me just flipping the picture up and down. And if you take a look at that video where I do the tutorial for doing the day to dusk edit, I show how to do this as well. That's all up to you on whether you feel that would be necessary for your shots as well. In this case though, it was basically the same footage where I'm capturing just a variety of a few different things that I can then edit together. And then of course, I change out the sky, and there you have a nice twilight shot.